Dear students, good morning. Dear students, I hope you all are at your home and safe from COVID-19. Students, today I am present here with new chapter of book 2 of Geography, India, People and Economy. Students, from this book, the first chapter is Population, Distribution, Density, Growth and Composition. Under this chapter, we studied about in detail of the Indian population and their features under the different topics as introduction, distribution of population, factors of the uneven distribution of the population, density, growth, composition of the population, etc. So let we start the chapter first, population. First of all, we discuss about the introduction and we come to know about this chapter of GIST. Students, we know very well that the people are very important components of any countries. We already taught in first book of geography, that's fundamental geography, in chapter 2, the world population. But in this chapter, we study in the context of Indian population. Friends, we know that India is the second most populous country of the world after China. India's population, according to census 2011, is 121.085 crores. You know that India's current population, it's the latest population, is 139.17 crore. And China's current population is 143.93 crores. Students, you should know one thing more, that India's population is larger than the population of North America, South America, and Australian population put together. This is the introduction of the population of India. So, students, now it's the next topic is distribution of the population. In second chapter of the first book, we talked about the uneven distribution of the population. Same condition in the India is also. In India, the populations are not equally distributed on the land area. So, in India also, population is distributed unevenly. There are so many factors we discuss in further. Students, Uttar Pradesh has the highest population, followed by Maharashtra, Bihar, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. You know, Uttar Pradesh is the highest population. That's 19 crores persons are lived in Uttar Pradesh. As Maharashtra, Bihar, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh has also a largest population concentrated in these areas. Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, with Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Karnataka, Gujarat account for 76% of the population of total population of India. So, you think about that, the 76% of the population of Indian total population, it's contain the these states. And other, Arunachal Pradesh takes 0.11% and Uttarakhand 0.83% of the total population, and Jammu and Kashmir is also, it's a 9.98% population. In spite of these states having large geographical area, so you think that these states, these few states has the large areas, but the population is very less. Why? You think about that. Students, these data shows that the in India population distribution is very uneven. Why? So we discuss about why and come to know the reason why these population are distributed uneven on the Indian land area, Indian vast land area, 3.28 lakh square kilometer. It's a vast land area of the India, but population are distributed unevenly. Why? We discuss under this topic factor responsible for uneven distribution of population. First factor is physical factor. Under this physical factors, it's a some topics which are affected the population concentration. That's the climate, availability of water, trains, it means the landforms, transmittal landforms, and transportation system. And second topic is socioeconomic factors. Socioeconomic factors, so settled agriculture, agricultural development, patterns of human settlement, development of transport, industries, and urbanization. And third one, it's a very important historical factors. The development of cities such as Mumbai, Kolkata, Chennai by the British. So let us discuss one by one the physical factors, socioeconomic factors, and historical factors. The physical factors first, the climate. Students, one question came in your mind that how the climate affects the population. So, climate is very important factors of the nature. You know that all peoples wanted to facilities, wanted to easy way living life. So, climates help us. And so in India, we know very well that the monsoon types of the climates over the Indian land areas. So climates are also, it's affected of the population concentration, the land area. Suppose the mountain range, in the mountain area, it's a so cold region. Cold climate, it's a contain, and in the plain area, it's a moderate climate, tropical humid climate, and the hill areas or plateau areas has also a hot climate, it's a, in these regions contain. So these types of the climates are all largely affected the population concentration, population settlement of the region. Water availability is also a great influencing factors of the population, because water availability is very important for the people, because water is lifeline of the person. And therefore, the water is very important for the everyone, every living things, not only human beings, but every living things. So water availability is most important things. Trains, landforms are also, it's a very important to settlement of the humans, settlement of the population in region. Like in mountain region, it's a difficult, so difficult to settlement there. And settle their house, settle their agriculture and different things are also, and water availability are also not properly defined. So it's a very difficult to settle there. And transportation system are also are very important, because in the hilly areas and in the mountain region, transportation are not properly developed. So these regions are affecting to the population settlement. Now second is the socio-economic factors. Now socio-economic factors, it's a very important factors, the affecting factors of the population, because settled agriculture peoples and mostly peoples are selected that region where the appropriate and favorable condition for the agriculture development areas and patterns of the human settlement, and in these region where the agriculture are very developed condition, in the very developed condition, their human settlement are also, it's a large population attracted to that regions. Development of transportation are also, it's a very important, because transportation system are convey, it's a medium of the convey communication and transportation from one place to another place things. Industries are also, it's a measurement of the development of region, and industry where the industries are established there in that regions are many opportunities are also opened, and job opportunities, education facilities and other things. Urbanization are also, it's a measurement of the facilities, different types of the facilities, just like education, health facilities and settlements and colleges, schools and markets are also. So these socio-economic factors are very important for the settlement or concentration of the population in that regions. The historical factors, we know very well that the when the British government came in India and they started to the rules in that time, first of all they reached the Mumbai, Kolkata and Chennai on the coastal area. So they developed first these areas as a metro cities, and population and peoples are attracted by these cities for the facilities, giving by the facilities. So in these areas are mostly population concentrated. So students, we talked the in these parts the introduction of the population distribution, density growth and composition, distribution of the population and factors responsible for the uneven distribution of the population. In second part of this chapter, we discuss about the density of the population and growth of the population and phases, different phases of the growth of population in second part. Thank you.